Hi, Chris Janok here at CES 2024. I'm in the private meeting room with CY Vision. They are a developer of automotive HUDs. They have a very unique design for developing their HUDs. So first of all, this uses a spatial light modulator and then goes through a more conventional mirror design to get up onto the windshield. Now, what's different about what they're doing here is they actually have two PGUs, projection units, with two spatial light modulators. Why do they have two? Create left eye and right eye images, so stereo pairs. And that's really a big advantage because they can now vary the parallax for the content that they put up to have continuous depth. So in their demo, that their demo is in back of me here, what they're showing here at CES. In their demo, they have a little game controller, actually, and you can move the images all the way from the foreground coming to about 1.5 meters, all the way out to infinity in continuous motion. So that's really important. And the way they create those images, since it's left eye and right eye, they also have an eye tracker, so they're tracking where my eyes are, obviously, and they're adjusting the interpupillary distance for my particular eye set so that I have good stereo vision. So that effect actually works quite well. So like I said, you have continuous movement of objects from foreground to background. Now, during the demo, there was a few things that I noticed, both positive and potentially areas for development. One, it's very, very bright. So they are able to, because of this architecture, they're able to get potentially up to 20,000 nits. So it's extremely light efficient because you're only generating a small pupil area around each eye. You're not filling the whole field of vision, the whole eye box with images. You're actually creating small little pupils of images that move around within a larger eye box volume. So it's very, very light efficient. The demo that they're showing here is about 15 by 5 degrees. I'm not sure about the look down angle. They have shown another prototype device that has the same 15, I think it's by 4 degrees, with a variable look down angle that's about 8 liters in size. If you want to standardize the look down angle, then you have to expand it to about 12 liters. So the very bright, optically efficient engine here. Now in the demo, since it is a prototype and they're not looking to go into mass production until 2026, there are some things they're going to have to work on. One, there was some image glow all around the eye box that was visible, and that's partly a consequence of the high brightness that they're doing and this very bright ambient environment. That's not going to be acceptable in a dark environment. They know this. It's stray light. This will be solved before they can go into production. Secondly, I thought the eye box was a little small. You got to keep your head in a fairly tight window. It's manageable, but it's a little tight. I think they recognize that as well and would like to improve that before they go into production. Third, this is an artifact of this particular demo, is that you've got, since you can create images that go out all the way to infinity, they have a second screen over here that's showing kind of video driving. That's at a fixed distance and it's a fixed 2D image as well. So the consequence is when you project virtual images that are beyond where that 2D screen is, you're actually creating stereo conflict and you can feel it in your eyes. Now, you may not recognize what you're seeing, but that's exactly what it is. It's a stereo conflict. Now, that's only an issue in this particular demo because that's a 2D flat screen. In the real world, when you're projecting virtual objects at infinity, that's not an issue because there's no stereo conflict. So very positive developments here. Some work to do, but I think they're on the right path with a really cool and unique solution. Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media.